My name is Sef McCullough, and I'm a high-end retoucher. What led me to retouching was working in computers, being interested in imagery, being interested in art, and just not really knowing exactly what track I was going to take. I didn't even know retouching existed as a thing for a long time. I was in production art. I started out in newsprint. So I think my first retouching job, I didn't know I was getting paid for retouching. I was just like, I'm doing like this layout for some kind of like hotel resort, and I have to make the image look better. The woman who was feeding me super low-end kind of local graphic design work, she ended up getting a job at babycenter.com, and they had just tons of product that they put online, so she hired me over there. And it was just to go in there and just do retouching on like strollers and car seats and stuff like that. And that was when I first got into like figuring out what a production workflow was like for Photoshop, because we were just clipping all day, doing basic color correction, matching to some product. And that was when all of a sudden I realized that I was a retoucher. And then occasionally we get some lifestyle images that come in that they need for the website. So I end up getting those. And then I was like, kind of doing higher level retouching and figuring that stuff out. Now I'm represented by an agency called Happy Finish, and I work a lot on Columbia, a lot of sports brands. I do a ton of Nike work. In the past, I worked on Old Spice, Coca-Cola, Levi's, Dodge Chrysler, a whole wide range of different kind of clients who do different kind of imagery, but all at a really high global scale. I don't really look at a whole lot of other retouching for inspiration. I go to other places because I think if you go to other places, you're able to bring something totally unique back to your craft. I look at painters a lot, and I'll go back to like some of the same painters. What did I go there for? Are color ideas and color realizations. I think as retouchers, we are so much more like painters in every way than we are like photographers. We use photography as raw materials to create paintings. That's the way that I think about it. What I want to see in an image of mine at the end or when it comes out is I want to see that I got something weird in there. And I'm not talking like creepy weird. I'm talking something unexpected that happens with color. Something that I got into that image that is non-traditional. It doesn't rely on a convention that we're used to seeing. If I can get something in there that somehow changes that vocabulary or adds to it, or gives people something different, just different to look at, then I can feel satisfied that I've changed something in the visual world that is at least shaking things up a bit and bringing a new, just something new to move that visual tradition forward.